In this video, I'm going to show you how to boot Kali Linux off a USB flash drive. This is a Windows laptop, but I've booted it from the USB flash drive. But not only that, I'm going to show you how to enable persistency. In other words, set up this USB flash drive with persistence so that changes that you make survive reboots. This is a Windows 11 laptop. In previous videos, I've shown you how to boot between Windows and Kali. In other words, enable dual booting of Kali and Windows. But you may not want to do that. You may want to run Kali off a USB flash drive so that no changes are made to the hard drive, as an example, on your laptop. Okay, without further ado, let me show you how to boot Kali off a USB flash drive, but also enable persistence. I'll insert the flash drive into my computer. And to install Kali, you need two pieces of software. You need to download Kali, which you can get from kali.org. We are not going to download installer images or virtual machine and the other options. What we're going to download here is the live boot image. We don't want to install Kali on the laptop. I showed you how to do that once again in a previous video. We are going to download the live image. It's about 3.8 gig in size. The next piece of software you need is something to write that image to the USB drive. There are multiple options to do this, but in this example, what I'll do is download Rufus. So you can get the software from rufus.ie. I'll scroll down and download the exe file. It's about 1.4 meg in size. Okay, so it's a fairly simple process. You need to download those two pieces of software. I'm going to run Rufus. The first thing you need to do is select your USB drive. So I've got 128 gig USB flash drive here. So I've selected that. Next thing I need to do is select the ISO image. Make sure that you choose the right image. And this is the important part. You want to set your persistent partition size. You could set it up to a bigger amount. But just for this example, I'll set it to, let's say, 65 gig. So half of the USB flash drive, or approximately half of the USB flash drive. You can give the volume a name. I'm just going to leave it at the defaults, Kali Live. So again, choose your USB flash drive. Secondly, specify the image to install. So the live image. And then you can click start to start your installation. We're told that all data will be removed, so that's okay. I'm going to click OK. Notice the USB flash drive is being formatted, and then the installation will start. Now, previously when I did this, it took about 18 minutes to install this. So now's a great time to go and get a coffee or do something else. It's going to take a while for this to install. Through the power of editing, we'll speed this process up. Basically, you just need to wait for the installation to take place. Okay, there you go. It's completed. It took about 25 minutes. And what we can do now is click close and reboot the computer. Now, you've got two options, really. What I'm going to do here is restart the computer while holding the shift button down. I'm going to click restart. You don't have to do that. What you could do, instead of holding the shift button down while it reboots, is just press the special key to reboot the computer into BIOS. Okay, so there you go. I can go to troubleshoot. Advanced options, UEFI firmware settings, click restart to reboot the laptop into its BIOS. Now, this is an Asus laptop, so I could have used F2 as an example to boot it into BIOS. That will really depend on your laptop. But there you go. I am in the BIOS utility. Now, there's two important things that we want to do here. The first thing is I want to move the boot priority to the USB thumb drive or USB drive and then Windows. And the second thing I want to do is I want to go to advanced mode here and go to security and turn off secure boot. Now, the BIOS on computers is different. You'll just have to go through the various settings to find those two options. You want to disable secure boot and you want to set the boot priority to the USB flash drive first and then Windows. So I'll click exit and I'm going to save my changes and exit out of the BIOS. So click OK. And what that should do now is boot off the USB flash drive and allow me to boot into Kali Linux. I'm going to press the down arrow. The option I'm looking for is a live system with USB persistence. So I'm going to select that and press enter. We want to have persistence once again so that settings are maintained, for instance, the Wi-Fi settings or a file that I add or other changes that I make to the system. And there you go, it's booted into Kali Linux. I can see various applications here, so it just looks like a standard Kali Linux installation. But let's do something here. What I'm going to do is open up the text editor, and I'll just create a file called test. So I'll save that to the desktop as an example, and give the file a name called test, and click save. So this file now, has been created on the desktop. Now, what I could do is connect to a Wi-Fi network, but I won't do that here. I'll be able to prove persistency by rebooting the laptop and making sure that that test file still exists. So what I'll do is restart the computer, and hopefully now it'll boot back into Kali, and I'll have my test file on the desktop. Okay, so I'm going to go back to persistence. So live system with USB persistence. Laptop is booting into Kali off the USB flash drive. And there you go, the test file with test in it is persistent. In other words, it survived the reboot. Now, if I want to boot into Windows, I can simply restart the laptop and then pull out the USB flash drive. So I'll do that, and hopefully it'll just boot into Windows now. You could obviously press the right key to boot into BIOS and then boot into Windows that way, but I've simply removed the flash drive from the computer. And there you go, I'm able to now boot back into Windows. If I want to boot back into Kali, all I need to do is plug the USB drive back in and then say restart. And then what I'll do is press F2 to get it to boot back into the USB drive. So what I'll do in BIOS is simply move the boot priority to boot off the USB flash drive, and then I'll save and exit. And there you go, I can select persistent USB drive once again. And I've once again successfully booted back into Kali Linux. Okay, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you found it useful. Very nice that you can boot Kali off a USB flash drive or dual boot it. Whole bunch of options available with Kali Linux. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel, liking this video, and clicking on the bell to get notifications. I'm David Bomble, and I want to wish you all the very best.